So what we saw here is that partial observability is really bad, as the ratio of variables observed approaches zero. We ultimately stop being able to fit anything meaningfully. Now, this is because there's a clear violation of unconfoundedness. But also, let's clarify where we are in neuroscience on this axis. We will typically record from hundreds or thousands of neurons. In fMRI research, we will, if we are lucky, record from tens of thousands of voxels. The brain is 10 to the 11 dimensional, so we are very, very far on the right-hand side here. So partial observability when doing such fitting methods is something that we should be very worried about. Now, that is because there's the unobserved variable bias. For linear systems, we can exactly understand these biases. They're impossible to get rid of because of unconfoundedness. And for most systems, there is no solution to the problem. Let me summarize what we just learned. In partially observed systems, model fitting fails to meaningfully reveal causality. And as the ratio of observed dimensions gets to be very large, we get to be very, very bad at estimating causality. The problem is bias introduced by unobserved variables. It's generally impossible to distinguish signals made by unobserved variables from true causal effects. There's an analysis principle here. Us neuroscientists should not claim causal inference for systems if the methods that we require have to assume unconfoundedness. We cannot have unconfoundedness, and that's why in most systems we cannot have causality, unless we perturb the systems.